today a professional logo design tutorial using Illustrator to make this cool professional logo design. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphical design content right here on YouTube. Remember to turn on your notifications when pressing the bell icon to stay updated to all of my uploads. To start this professional logo design tutorial in Illustrator, create the outlines of a single letter, and I used Arial Black for my font. Press A on your keyboard so you can edit the letter if you need to using the direct selection tool. You can move the letter as well as edit the shape via the anchor points. Move the letter to one side, as we need to use that later in today's Illustrator logo design tutorial. Press B on your keyboard to access the brush tool, and then draw out a shape like this. It really doesn't have to be neat, but it does need to connect at the very end, being one continuous line. Access the selection tool and flick the stroke to a fill to make sure that it's actually a connected shape. Move it to one side and then make another one in the same manner. You can hold down Shift to select multiple objects at once, and then change the stroke weight to something fairly thin. As you can see here, I have three shapes that look very crude, almost as if drawn by a toddler, but that's fine for our professional logo design in today's tutorial, as you will see later. Arrange them and rotate them in a similar fashion to mine here, and then select all three shapes. Go up to Object, Blend and Blending Options. You need to use specified steps, and you may need to experiment with the number of steps you use. Then go up to Object, Blend and Make. You may need to press Command or Control Z to move back a step and redo it until you're happy with how the design looks for your professional logo design. Here's my final shape, and hold down the Alt Option key to duplicate it, as well as the letter. Here is a quick bonus logo before we finish the tutorial today. Place the letter over the line shape, and then make sure the letter is brought to the front of all layers. Select everything, then right click and create clipping mask. This can be quite a cool effect for a logo design. Anyway, let's move on with our professional logo design. Bring the letter onto the canvas as well as the line design, and then open up the transparency window. Select the letter and copy it with Command or Control C, and then select the line design. In the transparency window, make a mask and uncheck clip. Then in the right window, press Ctrl or Command V to paste it in place. The letter is now cut into the vector design for your logo. To finish things off, you can change the color of your stroke here. And if you access the direct selection tool, you can edit the shape of your professional logo design. Take your time to play around with it until you're happy with how your logo looks. You can also change the stroke weight if you wish. So there is today's professional logo design tutorial brought to you by Satori Graphics. If you found it useful, drop a like and a comment on the video, and share the tutorial to somebody else on social media. Subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly uploads, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.